seen back. Psalms chapter 73. I've just been wrestling here with what I was to preach tonight. And this one's weighing more heavy on me, so maybe we'll preach the other one tomorrow night. I don't know. Psalms chapter 73. Thank you for the offering. May the Lord bless you for it, for everybody coming. Truly, God is good to Israel, even to such as are of a clean heart. But as for me, my feet were almost gone. My steps had well nigh slipped. For I was envious at the foolish when I saw the prosperity of the wicked. Thank you, Lord, for your words, your will, your way. Thank you for all these wonderful people that have gathered here under the sound of my voice tonight. Pray that you touch every heart, life, and soul that's gathered. Pray that we would leave here tonight saying it has been good to have been in your house. God, I just wish you'd come by in a real and a special way. God, help us to leave here, God, touched and changed and transformed by the power of God. We'll give you the praise, the honor, and the glory. And everybody said,
amen.
Amen. If I understood you, Dad, right? Would you say Sister Thelma has found her daughter-in-law? I got to thinking about, you know, we never know what tomorrow's going to hold. Last night, Sister Thelma was shouting all over this place. And today, she found out her daughter-in-law got a large mass in her, don't look good. I tell you, you gotta store up something tonight to take home tomorrow. Hello, we don't know what tomorrow is going to hold. So tonight, before I get to preaching, I'd like to encourage you, get in and get all you can tonight. Amen. So if the devil does come tomorrow, you'll have something to throw at him. Amen. You'll have something to go on, something to stand on. They used to say, get you something to eat, you're going to need your strength. Amen. And I tell you, somebody said, well, you better not get in, the devil will get you. He's going to be there tomorrow anyway. He'll be there, guarantee you. So just go ahead and get something tonight so you'll be ready for him and have strength to fight him. Amen.
Right.
I'd like to preach for just a few minutes tonight on slippery places. Slippery places, amen. I got to read here about David. I got to read the Psalm of Asaph. I say about David. I got to read about this man, and he looked out and he said, God is good, amen. He looked out and he said, God's good to Israel and everyone that's got a clean heart. But as for me, amen, I thought tonight how many of us could say that. We could look around, we could say, well, I know how they're doing, but what about me tonight? So many times we get caught up of looking around, whether it's for the good or for the bad, and sometimes we fail to just stop and do a little assessment of our own souls. Amen. We are so bad about God's word going forth, and we're looking around trying to see who they're preaching to, instead of saying, God, what can I get out of this tonight? What can I receive out of your word tonight? Amen. And all this psalm said, but as for me, my feet were almost gone. My steps had well nigh slipped as I looked out, and I was envious when I saw the prosperity, amen, of the wicked. I begin to think tonight, probably one of the number one causes, but two of the greatest causes of backsliding. I don't know if they are the number one, but two of the greatest causes of backsliding, amen, is people looking at others, amen, and watching others, and allowing others to get them down, and getting discouraged tonight. Two of the greatest tools the devil's ever used was to get people discouraged, amen, and to get people looking at others. But friends, tonight, I tell you, you get to watching others, and you'll find yourself in slippery places, amen. You'll find yourself doubting God. You'll find find yourself doubting your faith. You'll find yourself wondering. You'll find yourself questioning. I tell you what I'd like to do tonight. I'd like to get my eyes on Jesus Christ and Him only. Amen. If you and I could get our eyes on heaven, if you and I could get our eyes on Jesus, we would be a lot better off. For when we get our eyes on the wicked, when we get our eyes, amen, on the foolish, we will get in slippery places tonight. Stay with me here now. Kind of thought as Brother Mike was talking, amen, about holiness in the crossroads. I thought about a lot of people who are in slippery places tonight. Amen. As far as holiness is concerned, Brother Dominic, they ain't got their feet under them real good. Amen. They're just not sure which way they're going to slide. They just ain't sure which way they want to go. They ain't just sure which way. But I'd like to look at it this way tonight. Amen. Somebody here, and I don't have a doom and gloom message going to try and encourage you before this is over. But somebody here tonight needs to get your feet underneath of you. Amen. You're right on the edge of the cliff, so to speak. Amen. Now, I said you're in slippery places tonight. You need to make up your mind. I'm going to serve the Lord. I'm going to lay aside the world. I'm going to do what's right in spite of everybody else. I feel like tonight somebody in the house is in a slippery place. Amen. Woo. I got, you know, we as holding, just don't nobody get nervous. I got a lot of stuff I want to say here, just trying to get this started right here. We as holiness people, or should I say we as in the modern age, we don't realize as much how these old timers had to travel. When the psalmist said, "When my foot well nigh slipped," I can see him as he pictures himself on a narrow trail. A climbing higher, come on, out on the edge of one of those cliffs, out on the edge of one of those precipices. I mean, right there, Brother Nathan. And he says, and he said, I got in a slippery place. I mean, I was right on the edge. I want y'all to get what I'm talking about tonight. When he said my foot in, there's a hanky in that inside pocket. When the man said my feet got a slippery, it was life or death. Amen. Amen. I don't know about you tonight, but in my Christian walk, I have found myself in some slippery places. I mean, where one wrong step could mean life or death. Where one wrong choice could mean heaven or hell. Where one wrong move could be the end of my Christian experience. I want to tell you, friend, there's nothing like slippery places. And there's nothing as critical as a man, woman, boy or girl who's in a slippery place. Amen. Whoo! I watched our young people come pray last night. As I looked at them, teenage years or slippery years. It's just cornbread preaching tonight, I guess what you'd call it. If you want something to eat, you'll have to go somewhere else. Amen. But as I looked at our young people, and I talked to one of them last night, and I said, "You're in a critical time in your life." You see, one of the dangerous things about young people, though, is they don't realize how slippery it is. They don't realize that one wrong choice, amen, could forever mar and scar them. They don't realize that I'm just a kid, Brother Marquis. No, I talked to one. I said, "You're not a kid anymore. You're not a kid anymore." Amen. And you got to be careful. The choices you make, the decisions you make, amen, in slippery places, amen. Man, amen, because one wrong choice could send you hurling over the edge and falling into the flames of hell. Amen. Oh, we got some young people here tonight in slippery places. You know what it caused you to slip? When you get to looking out. You get to looking at the wicked. When you, oh my, you get to looking at those young people that's a partying and carrying on. and they get to telling you, well, I feel like I might just preach a little while now. I don't know if y'all want to hear it, but I might just preach here, man, if the Lord help me. And you get to looking out, and you get to seeing the world. Amen. And the devil says, they're the ones having the fun. All you got's a bunch of restrictions. All you got's a bunch of bondage. And if you ain't prayed up just real good and got your eye on the prize and realize that we're going for something higher, you'll get in a slippery place and you'll find yourself sliding. Amen. It wasn't one time was firm ground. It wasn't one time you believed with all your heart. You'll find yourself questioning. You'll find yourself asking. You'll find yourself doubting the preacher. You'll find yourself doubting the words of the evangelist. If you're not careful, you'll get in slippery places. Amen. Woo. Come on here now. As I look at our young people, and I'm not just going to preach to them tonight. I can remember. I'll just look at my life. I've said it many times, and I'll say it again tonight. If it had not been for the mercy of God, Brother Scotty, amen, and somebody praying for me, and God watching out for me, and knowing in my heart I want it right, man, I could have married the wrong person. I could have made a wrong choice that would have kept me from traveling this country. Are y'all here tonight? Amen. I talked to a young preacher last week, and he wants to evangelize, feel like God's called him to evangelize. I mean, he's got the talent, he's got the ability, he can sing, he can preach, but he's got a wife that says, I ain't a going, I ain't a doing it. Amen. One wrong choice, amen, may ruin him forever from doing what God wanted him to do. That's why I'm here to plead with my young people tonight, and you always just sit tight, I'll get to you in a minute. I'm here to plead with you tonight. You're in slippery places. Amen. I said you're in slippery places. And the only hope you got tonight is to get a hold of the rope or to get a hold of heaven and get a hold of something down here at these altars that'll give you some stable footing in this last day. Amen. Woo. The only thing that saved me was that service after service after service. I'd fall in that altar like I was backslid. And I'd beg God to help me, Sister Avril. I said, I'd beg God to help me. I don't want to go to hell. I don't want to make a wrong choice. Hey, hey, hey. It's the only way you can make it through these places. I said, it's the only way. Even I thought about here tonight. I remember several years ago at this church that Sister Avril got in some slippery places. Amen. Said, if I don't want to embarrass her, but she had an old sinner boy. Amen. That wanted her bad. He wanted to marry her, date her, I believe. Amen. My Lord, was after her soul. And I can remember who a young lady who doesn't want to get married. A nice looking young man. I met him one time. But I can remember service after service. Sister Avril in this altar crying her eyes out. You know why? She was in a slippery place. She realized one wrong choice could send her over the edge. Could damn her soul forever. Amen. But she found a rock. She found something to hold on to in the slippery places. Woo. Some of y'all done got so old, you forgot what it's like to be a teenager. You forgot the highs and the lows, the ins and the outs, the ups and the downs, and the slippery places. Wish I could preach a while tonight. You know what? I'm glad I had an altar. I'm glad I had somewhere to pray. But I'm glad I had a mom and a daddy. Oh my. I want to tell you what helped me through the slippery places. And I've said it many times. I don't mean to bore you. But all the times I walked down those stairs and caught my daddy kneeling beside that lazy boy, saying, God help my teenage boy. Devil, you can't have him. Devil, you're not going to get him. Devil, you can't have his soul. Amen. I had something to hold on to in the slippery places, brother Johnny. I said I had something. And your boy... And your girls are getting slippery places. But if you can give
give them something to hold on to. I said, if you can give them a rock, if you can give them an anchor, if you can get a hold of something in this last day, we can make it through the slippery places.
I picture teenagers in this church. Oh, this ain't really in my notes. I ain't even got started yet. Pray, we're going to be here a couple of hours. Please. I can see them. Slippery places. Feet's right on the edge. If we don't get them soon. Huh? Y'all here tonight? I can see the edge breaking away under their feet. And they're reaching out for something. They're reaching out for a hand. They're reaching out for something. They're reaching out for somebody. They're in slippery places. My God, tonight, I wish I could get a hold of something to reach my hand out. But you see, the problem is if your feet ain't got nothing to hold on to, you ain't gonna help nobody. Come on here now. Hey, I said, if you're going over the edge with them, you can't help them, amen. I hear a mom and a daddy. I can hear you right now. Brother Brent, I brought my kids here. I'm hoping you can help them. They're getting rebellious. They're getting wild. Well, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll preach till my sides hurt. And I lay in bed, my sides ache. I'll preach till the sweat rolls. I'll reach as far as I can reach. But when I've done all I can do, mom and daddy, you're going to have to get a hold of something. You're the ones that's got them 24/7. And you're going to have to get some solid footing so that you can help them through the slippery places. Whew. If you don't get on some solid ground, you'll never help them through these places. Whew. I was envious at the foolish. You know what? As I read this psalm, as I read this, I have to, in my mind and in my heart, I have to believe that this man must have just had his eyes on, it must have been somebody that just constantly bugged him. Because what he said is not true of the world. He talked about how there's no bands in their death. He talks about heaven. He talks about their strength is firm. Amen. They're not in trouble. Well, that most every sinner I know is in trouble. But the devil just had one or a group or something that he constantly got his eyes on. And he said, look at them. Look at them. Come on. The devil's always got one. He's always got one or two. Well, you know, there's a preacher over there, and he's got a television, and he still shouts and speaks in tongues. He'll always get you on one. There's somebody over there, they cut their hair, wear makeup, and I felt someone, they come on here now. He's always got that one. Amen. But when you look out at the world tonight, if you look at the whole picture, amen, the church world in general is going to hell in a handbasket. There's no power. There's no anointed. But if you're not careful, he'll have you looking out. He'll get your feet in slippery places. Amen. I'm going to tell you how slippery this thing got. They said, behold, these are the ungodly who prosper in the world. You know what he said? Verily, I have cleansed my heart in vain. When the devil gets you so low that he has you believing you're just living this wholeness way in vain, you're in slippery places. Come on here now. Oh, this AC looked out. He said, I've washed my hands in innocency. And look at me, all the day long I've been plagued and chastened every morning. Amen. They have no sickness. They have no problems. If you're not careful, the devil will have you off in a corner somewhere. He'll have you feeling sorry for yourself. Amen. Everybody else has got money and I ain't got none. Everybody else has got new cars and I don't. Everybody else has got this and that. And if you're not careful, you'll find yourself in a slippery place. You'll find yourself jealous. You'll find yourself envious. You'll find yourself with a bad spirit. You'll find yourself on the edge of a cliff somewhere. My God, get your eyes on Jesus in this place tonight. Oh, come on now. Yeah, hallelujah. This really bothered me. I read through this today, studying, seeking God. I read through this, and I had to study this out. This man said, if I say this, behold, I should offend against the children, the generation of thy children. When I thought to know this, it was too painful for me. Amen. And as David looks, this writer looks out, and he looks out, he says, I guess I'm going to be the first one, amen, of the homeless people that's going to go under. He said, I looked out, and he said, I was going to tell everybody my feelings, how that my feet were slipping, how I'm envious of the wicked, and how God doesn't care about the righteous. But he said, how am I going to tell this to all these generations who have said, God is my rock, my sword, and my shield? I'm going to be the first one that's going to go under. I'm going to be the first one that loses out. And he said, when I said this, it was too painful for me to think that I was going to be the one that was going to give up and go under. And God wasn't going to help. Amen. I've been where this man was. I can tell by how spiritual y'all are trying to look tonight. You've never been there. But I've been there. When the devil got me looking out, and the devil said, look at all them other preachers out there, what they got. And you can't even keep nothing running. I mean, you got in the car and you prayed before you left, keep me from accidents. And you didn't make it to Oklahoma and you wrecked. You asked God to watch over you and keep you. You didn't get this far and you done this. And the devil's right there saying, yeah, look at the wicked. Y'all ain't here tonight, are you? Look out at the wicked. Look on the other side of the fence. They ain't having wrecks. They're not having breakdowns. Oh, God, the Holy Ghost tonight. They're not having trouble with their bills. I mean, everything's going good with them. They got plenty of money in the bank. And they drink like a sailor and curse like a fish. Well, I guess God just forgot me. But he said, when I thought on this, it was too painful for me to bear. To think that God didn't care. To think that God didn't see. He said, I just couldn't say it. Feel like I'm preaching to somebody right now. Look at them other preachers. I'm struggling. I ain't got this. I ain't got that. Feel like there may be a preacher here tonight in slippery places. I feel like there might be a preacher here tonight in slippery places. I was envious. I looked out and I said, look at the wicked. Look how God blesses them. And look at me. I'm driving old junkers. I can't even hardly make it. My bills is piling up. When I saw the prosperity of the wicked. Oh, my preacher and I, Brother Dominic, will the devil not get your eyes locked in on some one individual? You can look out the world and they're broke and hurt and they're waste their paychecks. Hey man, me and Nathan got a friend and some of the others here. His name is Jay. He had a girlfriend live with him for 14 years as a wicked sinner. He said last year, if he can estimate it right, she gambled away $150,000 at the Charlestown racetrack. But we don't see them. But the devil won't let us look over there. He wants us to see some old cursing, swearing sinner that we can look at and say, look at them. I know it's a strange preacher, but I felt like preaching on slippery places. Look at them. Amen. Look at that preacher. He don't preach no wholeness. His church is packed out. He's got this. He's got that. Look over there. No, come here and help me now. There's a young man in this church tonight. If you don't get your eyes back on Jesus, you're going to fall off the edge. If you don't get your eyes on heaven, there's a mom and a dad here. God's warned you and told you, but because you can't keep your nose on your face, and you've always worried about everybody else, you've gotten a slippery place tonight, and you're right on the edge. My God, get your eyes back on Jesus. I just preach a while now. They aren't sick, and I'm always sick. I'm just reading what A says. He said, I have been all day long, I've been plagued. He said, when my feet well nigh slipped. But I ain't done yet. He said, I've cleansed my heart in vain. Washed my hands in innocency. And when I thought to know this, it was too painful for me. But Eli, I like what he said next, Brother Ryan. Anybody here know what he said next? Are y'all here tonight? Until I went into the sanctuary. Whew! I don't feel like preaching a wild night. Until I got in the presence of God. And then I understood their end. Whew. Hallelujah. Oh, amen. Until I got in the house of God and I realized that money ain't everything. Until I got in the house of God and I realized I don't care if everybody in town's a hypocrite. Until I got in the house of God and I felt the Holy Ghost flood my soul. I said, until I went into the sanctuary. There's something about the house of God tonight that'll help you out in slippery places. I said, there's something about the house of God and the touch of God that'll help you through slippery places. When the Holy Ghost passes by, when the preacher gets to preaching, when the singers get to singing, he said, until I went into the sanctuary, then I knew their end. Amen. Oh! Come on here now. Let me try to preach this to you if I can. He said, let me tell you about them. Surely thou didst set them in slippery places. Thou casted them down into destruction. How are they brought down into desolation? As in a moment they are utterly consumed with terrors. He said, thus my heart was grieved. I was pricked in my reins. So foolish was I and ignorant. I was as a beast before thee. I'm going to tell you, I don't know about you, but I've gotten church before, and I felt so stupid. God, why'd I ever doubt you? God, why didn't I trust you? Y'all looking at me way too spiritual tonight. Get in the house of God and say, Lord, why couldn't I believe you? Why couldn't I? He said, I was like a beast. I was dumb before you. When I realized, God, you've got it under control. God, think this thing's going to wind down. God, this thing's about over. When I went into the sanctuary. Yeah. Let me tell you something. This right here lights your fire, even if your wood is wet right here. I'm telling you. He said, not me, but this word of God right here. Nevertheless, I am continually with thee. Now, you get this. Now, this is not God speaking. This is not God saying, I'm always going to be with you. This is the writer. He said, he's telling God, I'm continually with you, Lord. I've been to the sanctuary. I have seen your presence. And God, I just want you to know I ain't going nowhere. Preaching on slippery places. He said, nevertheless, I am continually with thee. Amen. Thou hast holden me by my right hand. I thank God. That right hand signifies power in the word of God. He said, Lord, I'm still here. My feet well nigh slipped. I was envious. But when I went in the sanctuary and you took a hold of my hand, amen, I'm going to stay, God. I believe I'm going to make it. Hallelujah. I come to preach to every young person in this place tonight. If you can get your hands in the hand of God, there's not enough devils in hell to drag you out. I said there's not enough devils in hell to drag you out. There ain't nothing keeping you from staying saved. There ain't nothing keeping you from going on. There ain't nothing that can stop you if you got a hold of his hand. Praise him tonight. What do you need when you're in slippery places? You need somebody to hold your hand. And Brother Dominic, he said, thou hast hold of me by my right hand. I'm staying. I'm continually with thee, Lord. And I like this. You need someone to guide you through slippery places. Thou shalt guide me with thy counsel. And afterward, receive me into glory. Are y'all here tonight? David said, I got a hold of your hand, and you're leading and guiding. And when I get through these slippery places, I'm going all the way to glory. Whew. I hope this is all right here tonight. You see my old uncle standing up wearing the green shirt. He used to wear that purple shirt. We called him Barney. See, I prayed through. Get my feet on the rock. I'll tell you, Uncle, tonight. Amen. If you can get a hold of his right hand and get him to lead and guide you. Afterward, thou shalt receive me in the glory. Brother Nathan McDonald, have you ever been in slippery places? Aren't you glad there was somebody that could get a hold of your right hand? That there was somebody that give you a little counsel? And afterward, after it's all done, after I've made it through the slippery places, I'm going to glory. I'm going to make it all the way to the end. I'm not going to stop till I run through those pearly gates. I'll talk to a sinner today. I'll backside, and I told some of you about it. I won't call his name. He's kidding to me. I begin to talk to him. He called up to talk to Dad. Just so happened I answered the phone. And I began to talk to him. I said, you come in church tonight? Oh, yeah, I'll be there. He just made me. I said, you come? I'm going to hold you to it. He said, yeah, I'll be there. I said, he said, I'll tell you what. He said, when you get all those sinners you already got there saved, that's on the platform, he said, then I'll come. First thing I told him, he said, you work on him first. I said, I've already been working on him. Not that I'm anything great, but I said, I've been working on him. And this is what I told him. I said, if you don't thank God to help us, I said, my brother been fasting all week. I said, that ought to tell you we're having revival. Huh? That's what I told him. Whew. I began to tell him, yeah, we've had a few on slippery places, but they're getting their feet under them. They get a hold of it. They getting prayed up, prayed through. And then I went on to tell him, because see, and be not careful, he's one of them that you could look out and say, look at the wicked. They're prospering, doing better than they've ever done. But this is what I told him this morning, because I felt the Holy Ghost boldness come on, and I've been known to make a few bold statements, what they tell me. And I just said, well, I'm going to ask you something. I said, when you're climbing the charred walls of hell, I said, who cares what the rest of them live like?
Yeah! 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 Yeah!
lift your hands and worship the Lord in this place tonight. Worship the Lord tonight. Hallelujah. Did y'all hear the Holy Ghost tonight? He said, grab hold of my hand. That's what the Holy Ghost said. And I'll bring you through. Amen. He said, grab hold of my hand. Come over here, Brother Nathan. You're just going to use you tonight. And the Holy Ghost spoke, now you're in slippery places. Come on now. But he said, grab hold of my hand. The Holy Ghost is saying tonight, you don't have to fall. You don't have to go to hell. You don't have to backslide. I'll hold you. I'll be there for you. I'll tear you up, let you dash your foot against the stone tonight. I got to feel the Holy Ghost. I said the Holy Ghost is here tonight. Ain't nobody got a backslide. Ain't nobody got to go to hell. Because he said, give me a hand. I'll bear you up. Amen. I know my shirt tail's hanging out. I ain't looking too dignified. But I'm feeling good right now. And I'm going to hurry and close. Whom have I in heaven but thee? And there is none upon earth that I desire beside thee. You're here tonight. Brother Brent, I'm confused. What are you confused about? I don't know about the wholeness part of it. I don't know. I don't know about this. You're in slippery places where you are. What you need to do tonight is get God's hand and realize that you are dying and shriveling up and say, God, you just take my hand and help me to go the rest of the way. You got your eyes on this. You got your eyes on the standards. You get your hand in his. He'll take care of all that. I marvel how people struggle with things. And they say, I just can't, I can't, I can't. No, you can. You can't. But when you get your hand in his. Whew, how many years, Uncle Curtis, you've been struggling with that television in the basement? Did you tell me it's gone? Huh? I can't get rid of it. Yeah, you can. Amen. About 2 weeks ago, Marco unhooked his internet and the television. He's got a wife that ain't saved. And, everybody say do this or that. But I want to tell you tonight. Come on here tonight. I want to tell you tonight, when you give God your hand, you can come out of slippery places. I say, when you give God your hand, you can come out of slippery places. Hey, young lady, you say, I can't make it. Yeah, you can. But when you give your hand to God, you can make it through slippery places. I'm about to fall. No, you ain't. Just give God your hand. You can make it in the slippery places. I'm trying to quit and I'm not doing a good job here. My flesh and my heart faileth. Still reading about Asaph. But God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. It is good for me to draw near to God. I have put my trust in the Lord God that I may declare all of thy works. Thank God, Asaph, you made it. You went into the sanctuary. Amen. You realize that the wicked's ends are coming. A judgment day will get here after a while. Amen. Give your hand to God. Let God counsel you, and you can make it through slippery places. I'm a closing with this. I told you teenagers, I told you I've been in some slippery places myself. Let's all stand over the house and I'll quit. I want you to get this here. Unless the Lord had been my help, my soul had almost dwelt in silence. The Lord had been my help, my soul had almost dwelt in silence. Oh my. When I said, my foot slipping, thy mercy, O Lord, held me up. How? Did y'all get that? When I said, my foot slipping, thy mercy, O Lord,
held me up. Great God. When my foot was falling, when I was in slippery places, and I said, God, I'm falling. Have mercy. Help me up. Psalms 94. Woo! Has His mercy ever held you up, Brother Nate? Has His mercy ever held you up, Brother Steve? Can you make it through slippery places? Has His mercy ever held you up, Brother Dominic, when you was over there? Where was you at over there in that place that you didn't have but just a few oodles of noodles, wasn't it? No money, and a roof fell in. I would say,
Antigua.
He said, Antigua. Whew. He said, Lord, my foot's a slipping. I ain't got no money, no food. My face about gone. Thy mercy, help me up. Did it not do it, Brother Dominic? Oh, hallelujah. Aren't you glad for that tonight? I'm here to tell you, some people here tonight on slippery ground. One wrong move, one wrong choice, one wrong decision could send you over the edge. But tonight, if you get your eyes on Jesus, whew, I'm glad that when you reach up as far as you can, it may not be but a foot off the ground, but you reach up high as you can, God will make up the difference. Whew, you reach as high as you can, God will make up the difference. I'm glad tonight, Sister Wendy, we don't have to fall. We don't have to slip. My, y'all looking, they, some of you are looking at me trying to fool me tonight, Uncle. They ain't got me or God, either one fooled. They've been in slippery places. They've been looking at the wicked. They've been looking out. They've been listening. They've been thinking, the devil's grass greener on the side. That old church up road from you has to have three services on Sunday, you know? They got like so many people. We could do that too if we just want to live like they live. We can't look at that. We're trying to preach holiness, live right. How the power of God is moving. Them boys over on the other side, they got this, they got that. You little poor preacher's kid, you ain't got nothing. You ain't probably got a bicycle to run. Oh, don't worry about that, boy. Hallelujah. We got God tonight. That's all that matters. Whew. I said, we got God tonight. And that's all that matters. Every head bowed and every eye closed. Lord, I know everybody in here tonight claims to be saved. There may be a lost person here, maybe a couple, but as far as I know, everybody claims to be saved. So I believe I'm preaching to the choir tonight, mostly. But there's some of you here, Brother Brent. I'd like to get my feet under me real good in this revival. I've been in some slippery places. But I want to get my hand in God's tonight. Hallelujah. I want to get my hand in God's tonight. Whew. Brother Nathan, go play the bass for me if you would. Hey, man, give me about the key of G, maybe. Hallelujah. I wonder if it'd be warm. We're going to start singing tonight. If you're here tonight and you say, Brother Marquis, my feet's slippery places, I want you to get out of your seat and come right now. Well, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. And no matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. Come on, step out of your seat right now. I want to make it, Brother Brent. I want to make it, amen. You don't have to worry. You don't have to be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. Troubles, they don't last always. For we have a friend in Jesus who wipes every tear away. So if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand, and no matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. Oh, is there anybody else right now? Oh, thank God. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Right here we have Brother Tom and Sister Francis. I'm here to tell you, a few weeks ago they was in slippery places. But I'm watching as God's giving them something to hold on to. And they're getting their feet on a solid rock. They got a foundation under them. Praise God. And you're here tonight. Amen. If you don't believe it, they testify to it. And you're here tonight. You're in slippery places. You need to come to this altar tonight and say, God, I'm putting my hand in yours. I've got to make it. Amen. I've got to make it. Amen. I want my kids to make it. Come on, young lady, young man. Get out of your seat. Come this altar. Preacher's daughter right here tonight. Preacher's daughter. You're struggling. You're struggling. But you got a desire for God. Get out of your seat. Come down here to this altar. Say, Brother Ben, I want to make it. I want my feet to be in some slippery places. Preacher's kid here tonight. Come down this altar. Say, God, I want to make it. If your tests and trials, they seem to bring you down. If your friends and loved ones are nowhere to be found, remember there's a friend in Jesus who wipes every tear away. Oh, so if your heart is broken, oh, lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. We're just going to wait here just a minute. If you're in a hurry, you just slip out quietly. Oh, no matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. You've been in slippery places, sis. Come down here to this altar. Let the Lord strengthen you tonight, sis. Hallelujah. Oh, no matter what may come my way, my life. That's right, sis. Come out here. Let the Lord help you. Oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. Oh, no matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. Oh, with Jesus, I can take it. Hallelujah. With him, I know I can stand. Oh, no matter what may come my way, my life is... I feel good. We don't have church around here tonight. I wouldn't leave if I was you. We're just getting started right now. You say, well, I don't know. I say, you just believe me tonight. The Holy Ghost is going to help us around here. We're going to have church before this thing's over. Hallelujah. Oh, with Jesus, I can take it. Oh, with him, I know I can stand. Oh, no matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. If your friends and loved ones seem to bring you down, if your tests are nowhere to be found, remember there's a friend in Jesus who wipes every tear away. So if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. Oh, no matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. Oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. Oh, no matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. Oh, with Jesus I can take it. With him I know I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. Oh, well, I know that I can make it. Oh, I know that I can stand. And no matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. Oh, with Jesus I can take it. Oh, with him I know I can stand. And no matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. Oh, come on. I can make it. I know that I can stand.
No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. I know that I can take it. With Jesus, I know I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. My life is in your hands. Well, Jesus, I can take it. With Jesus, I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. I know that I can make it. I can stand. What comes my way, my life is in your hands.
Come on tonight. Come on, young ladies, right over here in this corner. We can have revival right over here. We can have revival right here in this center aisle. We can have revival over here to the left. I'm here to tell you there's a rock to stand. There's a rock to stand on. You can make it. In slippery places, amen. Woo! Oh, you don't have to worry. Don't you ever be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. Troubles, they don't last always. For we have a friend in Jesus who wipes every tear away. So if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, I know that I can make it. Oh, I know that I can stand. And no matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. With Jesus, I'm going to make it. Oh, with Him, I know I can stand. And no matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Can we have some praying saints around here tonight? Let's seek God for a while. Woo!